I know when I was growing up, I didn't want to be a girl, and I don't know how many of you here feel the same. It's not difficult to understand why. India's daughters are unsafe, unwanted, unequal, unfree. Two rapes reported each hour. And I say this with great shame, that India has become the rape capital of the world. One third of the world's child brides, I call them child slaves, are in India, 5 million. They are unwanted in the womb. Almost 1 million girls killed in the womb each year. And 50% married women report domestic violence. Probably the rates are much higher. You know, one of the most used words in the English language these days is terrorism. And we're all very concerned. But our daughters, the girls, are under threat of terror each day of their lives. And nobody seems to care so much about this gender terrorism. I was training some male principals in Rajasthan, 70 schools, 70 principals, all male. There was a lot of resistance. But at lunchtime on the second day, this one principal walked with me. And he says, "Madam, ek baat kaho." I said, "Kahiye na, sir." So he said, "Main sochta tha ki ye jo gender ki baat hoti rehti hai, khansi zukam ki tarah hai aur baar baat ka patangar bana dete hain log. Lekin aaj samajh mein aaya ki ye to cancer ki tarah hai, isko bahut seriously lena chahiye." I said, "Shukar hai, sir." And I want to echo his voice. Gender discrimination has lethal consequences. Our daughters are dying and we should take it seriously. You're probably wondering that why on a nice day like this, we are all having TED Talks, am I telling you all these bad, bad things? And what has it got to do with education? I think it has everything to do with education. Because education is not just to know, the goal of education is to live. And education for girls is so that they can have better lives. So we must look at what their lives are like. You know, in the last decade and a half, people have suddenly woken up to the value of girls' education. Educate girls and there will be many developmental benefits for countries and economies. I don't know why this is rocket science. I mean, it's common sense that if you leave half the world behind, clearly the world is not progressing. So then they came up with the thing that if you want gender equality, then you should get all the girls into school. They found there was a big gap. And India and China, in fact, have done the best to bring their girls into school. The trouble is, they're coming into school, but they're not staying. And so because they're not staying, they're not learning very much. And why are they not staying? Because they are girls. Because girls must step in for their mothers when they have many babies. They must step in when they are sick, they must step in when they die, and they get married off very early. So then they said, no, they must complete a high school, high quality, high school education, then things will get better. So let me give you an example of someone who completed a high quality high school education, right before you. I went to a very good school in Pune and I finished on top of my class in class 12. Within a year, my father, he's a wonderful man, not there anymore. He found a suitable boy and my marriage was fixed. And my brothers went on to get degrees in science and engineering. And when I was engaged to be married, I didn't even question why, because ladkiyon ke saath to aise hi hota hai. We are meant to be valued for our reproductive labor, for our sexual labor, for our domestic labor, and girls must be married off. All my life, my brothers would play cricket, and I would iron the clothes. They would read books, and when I was reading something, my father would walk in and say, "Ki tumhe koi kaam nahi hai kya?" So I learned, now when I saw him coming, I would sit on my book. And then I would take care of the younger brothers and sisters, and they would read comics and go out and play. Did I question it? No. Did I mind it? Yes. But I didn't question because I thought that's what happens to girls. Let's think of the girls who get masters and bachelors and PhDs. Do they feel equal? And my high quality education in this high quality school, was it really a quality education? I question it. It taught me many skills, but what did it not teach me? A very valuable lesson. It didn't teach me that I was an equal person. It didn't teach me that I had a right to live my life according to my own choosing. It never gave me any aspirations beyond wanting a nice husband who I hoped would be kind to me. Let me tell you another story of a girl who had a high quality education in a high quality school, the same school, my cousin. She also got a bachelor's degree, she was lucky. And then she was married to a chartered accountant in Delhi. 4 years after she was married with a two-year-old daughter, my mother called me from Pune and said, ki wo to jal gayi. I said, jal gayi? She says, haan, stove phat gaya. In the 80s, bahut stove phatte the, aur sirf auraton ke upar phatte the. And I rushed to Delhi and found out that she had died by the time I reached, and then learnt, they said, no, it was a suicide. My father said, what shame she has brought to the family. My bua said, aajkal ki ladkiyon ko to bardasht thi nahi. She herself had a miserable life. My bhabi, who many years later, my cousin bhabi, died of an overdose of insulin, she said, ki chal, shanti hui, mukti mili. I asked her mother, I said, mami ji, aapko pata tha that she was so unhappy. So she said, dekh, shaadi mein khush kaun hota hai, par koi aise thodi karta. And you know, ladkiyon ke saath to. So tell me something, is this because, do we have gender inequality because of a lack of education? Because girls aren't educated? These were not uneducated people. Lack of girls' education is a symptom. The disease is a cruel, patriarchal social system that will keep half its population feeling unwanted, unsafe in the womb, on the streets, in their homes, and will give them away into child slavery. So it is the system that is at fault. That's what I learned. So what's the solution then? The solution actually is education. It is the magic bullet, but not any kind of solution. You need a different kind of solution. And let me tell you what I mean by that. This is Lakshmi. She's one of the past students of a school that I founded in 2003 called Prerna. She, both her parents are illiterate, were illiterate. They were laborers on construction sites. Her mother was 12 when she was married. By 23, she had 7 children, out of which only 5 survived. And she died at the age of 35. Lakshmi dropped out of school when she was 7 years old because she had to take care of the little children. And after her mother died, when she was 13, she worked in 7 homes, put her younger sister to work in 3 homes, and the 5-year-old would cook. And that's how they raised themselves. The father was drinking and was selling off their gas cylinder. They had to keep all their rations in a neighbor's house so that he wouldn't sell those off. Lakshmi found our school when she was 12 years old. Where is Lakshmi today? She has finished her bachelor's, she's earning 27,000 rupees, she's a supervisor in a call center, she's getting an MBA degree, and her company is paying for it. Not just that, she's a great advocate for girls' rights, she goes on panels, and she's campaigning in the community against domestic violence for girls. And how did this change happen? How did this happen so dramatically? You know, there were two very important lessons that I learned in my life, which I took when I formed the school for the girls. I'm a proud mother of 2 daughters. Jab pehli hui, to everyone said, chalo, koi baat nahi, next time you'll have a son. When the second one happened, I was terrified. I said, hey, Prabhu, beta ho jaye, sab marenge. And my mother-in-law is giving me all kinds of totkas and suparis and all. And I told her, I said, mummy, dhyan se wo kahin beech mein na reh jaye. Anyway, so lo and behold, I delivered this beautiful baby girl. When the doctor told me, I passed out. And then when I woke up, I wept bitterly, really wept bitterly. And I said, kya ho gaya? I said, you know, I felt so guilty. I thought I had absolutely destroyed the hopes of my family. And then, suddenly, I saw that she was treated, you know, not welcomed, koi laddu nahi, kuch nahi, koi aata tha, chaat pit pitte hue, ki hai hai beti ho gayi. And then I got angry. And they say anger is a revolutionary emotion. And then I said, what is her fault, this beautiful child, and what is my fault? And very soon, I woke up to the understanding, the one thing that has, which is why I'm here in front of you today, that I am an equal person, that I have the right to everything that anybody has, and that just being a girl is no fault. And slowly I began to protest, I began to resist, and what do you know? Everybody started to treat me as an equal person. The more I respected myself, the more other people started to respect me. And I learned the important lesson that we must learn that we are equal persons. The second important lesson I learned in my life was that after years of blaming my father and my brother and my husband and all the men in my life, I said, no, the problem is not with the men. The problem is with a patriarchal social structure that socializes them in the same way. And the social system, we must understand it, we must change it, only then things will change. And these are the lessons that I took to my school. We have 1,000 girls there now, and we have scaled our project to over 5 lakh girls. And what did Lakshmi... Not just Lakshmi, but many of her friends, Kunti, Khushbu, Aarti, Preeti, and recently Moni. What are the lessons they learnt that changed their lives? We made it our educational goal. We said these girls must learn, first of all, they cannot leave here. Along with maths and science, they must learn lessons of equality. They must learn that they are equal persons. They must learn that they deserve respect. They must learn that they have the right to do what they want for life. They are being educated so that they can give shape to their lives. And then they must get all the skills to achieve this. So did our girls finish 12? They didn't only finish class 12, but they grew up as empowered girls. And how did we do it? They learned to read and write, of course. But while they were learning to read, write, and do maths and science, they were learning lessons of equality. They were learning that the social system is cruel, that it gives them less of everything, and this is unfair. They were learning to protest. We used drama. And in drama, they learn to get angry in a very safe space. Ghar mein nahi keh sakte ho. Drama mein to keh sakte ho. They learn to rehearse resistance. And they learned that though everybody says, ki are, jab badi ho jaogi, apne ghar jana, and paraya dhan ho, apne ghar jana hai. When you get married and go home, to kehte hain, apne ghar se kya lai? Zaban chalai to ghar se nikal denge. Ghar wali ka ghar hi nahi. That marriage leaves you more homeless than ever. And this is not fair. Right. And they learned to build, develop strong voices for themselves, for their families, and for their communities. So they learned, we learned to move our teachings from learning outcomes to life outcomes. We have an 88% completion rate, which is double the national rate. And most of those girls go to college. Just yesterday, I heard that one of our ex-students, she has been the youngest nominee and now a finalist for the CII Women Exemplar Award. February 20th, the results will be out, I'm praying. And we have been able to reduce the rate of child marriage. And most importantly, we have been able to turn the parents around, the fathers around, and the brothers around. But our task was not complete. In fact, the parents said, what about our boys? Unke liye bhi to kuch kariye. And my first thing was, koi aur kare. And then I said, nahi chalo. Then I understood, no, the boys must, our girls are empowered, the boys must be empowered. So we started a boys' school, and there too, we teach the boys how to treat girls equally, and how do we do it? We teach them to empathize with their sisters, with their mothers, with their sisters-in-law. We told them that, what do you do during the day? Let's hear your routine. And they told us, and all the boys used to go out to play in the evenings. We said, interview your sisters and find out what their routine is. Of course, the routine was that they did all of the household chores, and the evening they stayed home and cooked. So I said, don't they go out to play? Don't they want to play? They said, nee, but if they go to play, phir ghar mein kaam kaun karega? I said, haan, and why can't you help them? If you help them, then you can both go. They said, haan. Okay, then we told them that you tell us that ghar mein, when papa mummy ko maarte hain, does the mother ever retaliate? They started to laugh. I said, bahar koi maarta hai, toh does she retaliate? She said, haan. I said, toh ghar mein kyun nahi? They said, because of society. I said, and is that fair? Then we spoke about dowry. And I must relate this very interesting conversation. So I said, you tell me who should stop the dowry? Shouldn't the girls protest? They said, nay, if they do that, then who will marry them? I said, and why should they marry someone who's asking for a dowry? Tell me something, when a girl sells herself, what do you call her? Prostitute. I said, and boy, to band, baja, barat se, they're selling themselves and nobody's calling them anything. Balki dhamake se, itne ka bol, utne ka bol. Then we taught them that, listen to me, how will your lives change? You keep thinking that you have to grow up and be the provider, only provider for your families. Do you? They will help you. You believe that you have to take care of your parents. Are your sisters will help you. And most importantly, dahej jama nahi karna padega. Because they will have equal marriages. No boys will sell themselves. No one wants to be a male prostitute. And so they understood. And so we are trying very hard that you can be a gentle, caring, nurturing, sharing man and still be a mard. And we are hoping together, along with all the young men and women here, along with the mothers here who must raise good sons, that together we will build a world in which everyone can feel wanted, be safe, be equal and free.